Conscience versus life force. The most relevant fact to understand this topic is to know the origin of human spirits. First, an analogy: with an online computer game, people of all around the world can participate by using an avatar, a digital being. A digital computer game reality is full of digital beings. A part of them controlled by the computer program, and another part controlled by human beings. The humans themselves, however, are not really situated within the digital reality, because as physical beings they are beyond of it, located within the life reality. Well then, kind of comparable, human spiritual beings are not really situated within the life reality, because in essence they are beyond of it, located within the transcendent human oneness. But humans have forgotten their natural position, and therefore they are just granting their inspiration, from the transcendent human oneness, to physical human bodies within the life reality, while they, as their true essence, are in some kind of hypnosis, or sleep mode. Furthermore, all human spirits are basically not present in the transcendent human oneness as separate individuals, but as one indivisible wholeness. Being an individual is just an illusory conviction, mentally imagined by the spirit himself, before he had forgotten about it, but the conviction still remains in his subconscious self. However, regardless of how bad a human has forgotten about his origin, about his spiritual oneness with all humans, the inspiration will always be active, coming from the transcendent human oneness. That everlasting inspiration reaches all humans, by means of their conscience, no matter how severely darkened it is as a consequence of their immoral acts. But the darker a conscience, the less the moral inspiration can have effect. So when a human considers to commit an immoral action against a fellow human, or when he is about to commit one, or during committing one, or when he is remembering an already committed one, the arisen conscientious sensation is caused by the moral inspiration of the transcendent human oneness. And so it goes for all human activities that go against the truth that all humans are essentially one and the same transcendent being. So the transcendent inspiration through the conscience urges on to humane acting, and to prevent immoral deeds against fellow humans. But then, what causes selfish, inhumane, and immoral acting? Again, an analogy with a digital reality of a computer game, but now a role-playing game in which only one digital being is controlled by a human. That digital being is subordinated to the nature forces of the digital reality. These forces are behaving exactly like they do because it is ordered in the computer game. They just automatically act exactly in accordance with how they are programmed. And that's the analogy with the life force of the life reality. The explanation of the fundamental order in the program of the life force could be reduced down to a command consisting of just a single word, which is, survive. The sole purpose of life force is to have its organism continue to exist. With this, morality is totally unknown for the life force. Animals can steal each other's food, and even kill for it, just for the sake of their own survival, without having even the slightest sense of guilt. And that's the difference between animals and humans. If the body of a human feels hungry, the life force can urge on to steal food from a fellow human, who is almost dying from starvation. But then there is the inspiration through the conscience, which is in conflict with the automatic reasonless command of the life force. And all this is an exact explanation of the conflict between the inner angel and devil of a human being who operates through a living body within the life reality. The only difference between a human and an animal body, is eventually the fact that the life force of a human body is controlled with mental energy done by a being who's endowed with reason. Although the corporal shape differs, the matter of which all living bodies exist, are eventually the same, and all those bodies are also obeying the same nature laws within the life reality. And that also goes for the life force, which is basically the same for an animal, as well as for a human body. You could suppose that an animal always operates as an autopilot according to a program. So this mechanism, or the influence of it, is also in force concerning to a human body. But with that, the human spirit could have the opinion that it is not always right to obey the orders and desires of the life force,